In this session, we will do a couple of recursive methods. So we will write the coding of the recursive method. So it says here, write a recursive method to do the following. The method, it says public static void display sharp integer n. So we will take a number and the method is void. So we expect no output. If the value of n is 3, then we have to display 3 sharp, 3 stars. If the value of n is 2, then we have to display only 2 sharp. So according to the value of n, you have to display number of sharp. So we will take a number and we will return nothing, a void method. And each time we have to display sharp. So let's think about of the method first and then we will write the coding of the method. So let's assume the following. If the value at the beginning of n is 2, it means I will have to display sharp and then 2 sharps at the end. If the value of n is 2, I need to think about it. How can we take it down till we reach a base case? So what I will suggest the value of n is 2, and then the value of n will be 1, and the last time the value of n will reach 0. If the value of n is 2, so I will display 1 sharp, and then I will call my method. If the value of n is 1, I will display 1 sharp, and then I will call my method. Of course, when you need to call your method, you need to change the value of n. So initially it's 2, minus 1 it will be 1, minus 1 it will be 0. When you reach 0, this is the end. This is where you have to stop, and then you will continue back. Already you displayed your sharp, so at the end already you have 2 sharps displayed. So by this, it means n0 is my base case where I have to stop. If it is not 0, I have to do 2 things. The first thing is I have to do the output of the sharp and then I have to call my method. So let's do the method together. This is the method signature, public static void display sharp. I will take an integer num. The first thing is if the value of num is 0, I have to do nothing. If you reach the value as 0, you have to do nothing, and this is by just going back. And if it is a void method, you can say return semicolon. So this means stop the method and then go back. If it is not 0, if it is a 3, if it is 2, if it is 1, what do you need to do? You need to do the following. The first thing you have to do is output the sharp. So you will output the sharp and then you will go to the next call. The next call, it says display sharp. This is exactly the same name we have at the top, display sharp. I will have to change the number. If number is 3, it should be 2. If it is 2, it should be 1. So I'll have to say num minus 1. And then this is will be the end of the else, and this is will be the end of the method. So my base case, if num is less than or equal to 0, I have to stop. And because it's a void method, simply I have to say return semicolon. If it is not, I have to output sharp and then I have to continue. So it's saying like this. If the value of n, for example, is a 3, so I will display sharp and then I will continue. If the value of n is 2, I will display sharp and then I will continue. If the value of 1, I will display sharp and I will continue. When I reach 0, this is the end and I will not do anything. So that's why we have to say return semicolon. So you need to do nothing and then you will go back and there is nothing to be done in your way back. And the output you have at the end, you have 3 sharp because the value of n is a 3. Now the question is, can I move the output just below the call? So can we just do this? Can I say system.out.print sharp after the calling? So I will call first. When I finish, I will come back and I will do the output. Yes, we can do in this example because it's only displaying sharp. So it doesn't matter, is it at the beginning or at the end? Always at the end, you will just have the sharps displayed. So if I will repeat it again, and I will assume now I'm saying I will call and then at the end I will do the printing. So if the value of, and let's assume now it's 2. So I'm saying I will call and then I will do the display. So it's more like it will be like this. So I'm saying you have to call first. So display sharp. and I will send num minus 1, and then I will do the output, and this is will be the end of the else. Now, if the value of n is 2, you have to call first, so I will call first, and change the value of num, so the value of num will be 1. If num of 1, again, you have to call first, so I will call first, and I will reach 0. When I reach 0, this is the end. Now, because now this is a recursive method, so I have to go back. When I go back, I have to remember this is an output I have to do. So I will output sharp here, and then I will go back and I will output sharp there, and we will go to the main. So at the end also we have two sharp. So it doesn't matter in this example if you have the output at the beginning or at the end, before the call or after the call, because only you need to display sharp. Now let's do the following exercise, will be similar to the previous one, but here we have to be careful which one we have to output first. It says here, you have to display sharp and star this time. If the value of n is a 3, you have to display 3 sharps and then 3 stars. If the value of n is 2, you have to display 2 sharps and then 2 stars. So we will think about it in this way. If the value of n is 2, what I'm expecting as output, as an output I should have 2 sharps, and then when I finish I should have 2 stars. So again I will follow the same technique. I will say n equal 1, the second call n should be 1, and the last call n should be 0. Here, because they mention you have to display sharp first, it means I have to output sharp and then call. So I will have to say here, do the output of sharp and then call my method. So, and then when you finish, you have to display the star. So I will do the output of sharp. So this is the first sharp, and then I will call my method. Still, we didn't reach the base case. Output sharp. So we'll output this sharp and then call my method. So I will call the method when I reach 0, 0 as the end of my base case. And then when I go back now here, when I have to go back, there is also one more statement which says display star, and that's why we will have a star here. Once we finish with the display of the star, we will go back. Then I have to display one more star, and this is a star, and this is will go to the main. So it says here as follows, the value of n as 2, you have to say display sharp and then go to the next number. The next number will be 1. Display sharp and continue. When you continue, you will reach 0. Once you reach 0, it means this is where you have to go back. When you go back, when you reach 1, you have to display a star. When you go to 2, you have to display a star. That's why in the output we have first sharp and then we have the star. Now the coding will be as follow, just like what we did in the previous example, the base case, if num is 0, return semicolon, and we mention semicolon because it's a void method, so we cannot have return a number, we just say return semicolon. If it is not a 0, it means I have to display and I have to call, so I have to display sharp first, and then I have to call, and then I have to display star. And I have to remember that when I call my method, I have to send num minus 1. And here, it will display all the sharps. And then once it will finish, it will display all the stars.